Good morning, everyone, my respected teachers and my dear friends. On the tantalizing morning of this holy day, with patriotic fervor and pride, on 15th January, each Indian fills his heart with immense respect and love for his motherland. Being the son of India, each year on this day, one unfolds the hues of saffron, pure white and divine green with salutes and tribute. Passed back, it was on this day of 1947 that the Indian independence along with its government came into being. On this very day, the Indian Independence Act was finally declared in this nation, unrolling the Indian tricolor in this nation's capital. Our leaders made beautiful memories with vibrant, radiating love for the nation. The independence that is freedom is that of the state in which its inhabitants or population or some portion thereof exercise self-government and sovereignty over the society. It is the sort of self-determination that focuses on exercising its power over population, definite territory, self-ruling government, and trying to be self-reliant. In short, it will be a self-sufficient state with affairs that will be settled by themselves and without any interference. Reminiscence of this glorious day, India declares itself to be independent in all respects and got freed from shackles of British imperialism. A struggle for about 200 years with submission, begging for mercy and a hope to live. Each day like a free bird, hope to win through all the battles, and finally a hope to visualize the dawn of rising sun. The nation has to let to India to learn how to fight back for every situation which come across to stop her. If you try to estimate the strength of India and its women, you get to see that it equalizes to live with the pain of dipping a tea bag in a cup of hot tea. The history of India and its independence is an epic in the freedom fight and a challenge to destiny. With the beginning of a new era, each year India tries to unfold the vibrant hues of home, progress and perseverance. We are diving deep into the reels of Indian history. We get to see how our freedom fighters and the sons of India fought for winning the battle and envisioned rising India to be an independent nation. Their invaluable sacrifice led us to live today in a civilized state, with each night sleeping comfortably in our bed. It is an inspiration to all our youth to have the courage and religiously celebrate the pride of being born in this country. The echoes of the patriotic song makes the ambience of this day to remold India has a unique identity. With the unfurling of the tricolor, Bharat Mata is secured from the clutches of the East Indian Company and the British rule, and what remains is our unity and ultimate strength and diversity. Being a nation with different cultures and inspired by the footprints of great men like Babu and Netaji, India seems to rule and understand every situation it thinks to handle itself with appropriate methods of begin. Being an extremist or an assertive one, the elixir of equality and justice, which our leaders have spread across the country, seem to be the biggest phenomenon that India could ever face. As the youth of the nation, it's our prime responsibility to sacrifice ourselves in contributing to our mother India. On this very day, we should pay a heartfelt tribute to the millions of martyrs of Mother India, the brave souls and the valiant soldiers, armed forces and our police, as well as our security forces, who have engaged their life in contributing and safeguarding our mother nation, should be rewarded for their rigorous preparations. Securing its full autonomy from the colonists, this day captures immense significance in the core of the Indian citizens living in any corner of this world, holding it to be a national holiday. This day seems to have an ambience of hoisting the national flag at all institutions as well as in our homes. The exhibition of the various art forms representing the tricolor, arrangement of various cultural programs as a tribute along with the synchronizing memories of the partition of India. Passed back on 15 August 1947, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, our former Prime Minister of India, unfurled the tricolor flag in New Delhi, the capital of India, at the Lahore Gate located in the Red Fort. Not only our freedom fighters, but also our fathers of the nation, that is Babuji, had fasted than in Calcutta and was living in the life of perfect saint with the promotion of Gandhi, and devoted his time to prayers and revolting against hatred. Once upon a time, India was termed to be a spice land, the place to be famous for its spices and masalas. With abundant resources and minerals, India was once termed to be the most attractive country in this world. When the British arrived and presented India in shackles, they began to misuse all the resources and started to collect all these valuable materials back to their country. Not only did they manipulate the rules, but also started to force ownership on India and its policies. They worked according to their whims and fancies and started implementing divide and rule policy, which shattered India into two parts. Parades are organized each year to pay tribute to all freedom fighters and to armed forces who each day protect us and secure us from antagonists. Therefore, it is on the 15th of August each year when we remember that being the citizens of India, it is our prime responsibility to uphold the virtues of a nation. Stand for a nation, be for nation, and be of the nation. The youth who are the pillars to uphold the virtues of tolerance, love, peace should have a fellow feeling that amongst the people and should have a warm blood to fight for our country. Each one of us should be inspired to look for the Swadeshi outfits and cater and the fraternity and freedom of speech that our country has given the right. The fundamental rights of India and its directive principle have always inspired us to be proud to be Indian. Freedom is the most loving aspect of this era. It is something which we pine for. On this auspicious day of independence, we all the sons of mothers India fight to win, because we don't have runners up on the battlefield. Let's salute the matrons who have let her flag flow high in the saffron and prosperous green hues. If your blood doesn't rage, then it is water flowing in your vein. For what is the flesh of your youth if it is not service to the motherland? Chandrasekhar Azad. At last, I would like to end my speech with a note of gratefulness and a bunch of thank you, gifting our country with the resplendent morning and paving the path for its independence, and some who became the epitome of simplicity, humility and wisdom. I pray to tribute the noble personalities on this religious day, not forgetting the Hadi man of India, who once brought the Satyagraha with some other, who brought in their seraphic ideologies of Swaraj of the masses and had led this day to the mother memorable on each year. Be their footprints, keep on guiding us in the creating an incredible, prosperous India ahead each day, blooming in it to make a better place to live in. Thank you.